So, good morning, Arie Van't Riet, and welcome to our magazine, Bo Live magazine. You are a physicist and an artist at the same time, an X-ray artist more precisely. What does your art and physics job consist of?
First of all, thanks for your invitation. It's me a pleasure to talk with you. About your question. Indeed, I am a physicist, but I do not know for sure if I'm an artist. I didn't have any artistic education at all. And I think, so I'm not an artist. If you call my images, my X-rays, art, that has to decide others. I cannot talk about that. Is it art or not? It's too difficult. But for sure, I'm a physicist. And your question was about, a physicist and how that job connect to each other, physicist and artist. Yeah, that's not so easy. I can tell about my physics background in physics. I studied physics at the Technical University in Delft, in the Netherlands. And my master was in radiation physics. I worked at the Reactor Institute in Delft. That's not a power plant, it's a research reactor. And then I switched. I did my PhD at the University Utrecht. And the subject of my PhD was the treatment of prostatic cancer with radioactive sources. Then I worked for many years, more than 25 years, in the hospital as a medical physicist. And I worked for the departments of radiology, radiotherapy, and the department of nuclear medicine. So that's all departments that use radioactive materials. That's about my as a physicist. And as an artist, of course I can tell why I started to make this images, these pictures.
Why did you start doing X-ray photography of nature, and how does your background in physics help you in this job?
Let's say in the hospital as a medical physicist, I also was involved in the education of the radiographers, the technicians, and the physicians. Education about the properties of radiation. And in that education, there was a practical session. We practiced with an old X-ray machine to learn about the properties of that X-rays. And at that moment, at some time, I took a flower from the garden nearby the hospital, and then I asked them to make an X-ray of a flower. And that's not too difficult, but it's, on the other hand, also not too easy. So it's a nice subject of object for practicing and learn about the amount of radiation you need, but especially how you can get an image, an X-ray full of contrast, how to do that. And you can't use high energy X-rays for a thin flower, the radiation passes through the flower, and it is not absorbed, and the flower isn't imaged, is not pictured. So you need low, very low X-rays. So that was nice to do, and the radiographers and the technicians, they liked it better than practicing with aluminium sheets and copper sheets and lead sheets and acryl sheets and all you can think about. So I sampled a lot of that images with flowers, and then at some moment I decided to add some color to some of the pictures, and I liked it. And that was it. But after a couple of years, now after many years, I retired. And from that moment on, I started to make my own X-rays with flowers in the beginning. But at some moment, I added some animals. Flowers need animals, and animals need flowers. They are together, and so it started, and then at some moment in 2013, I met a person who was curator of an exhibition in the Hortus Botanicus in Amsterdam, and he asked me to participate in it. And I think that was the beginning of the interest the people had for my X-rays.
A curious story, because also we here in Italy are interested in your creations. And I saw that you made really a lot of bioramas, is the name of your works. It's correct.
Yeah, I've chosen bioramas. Yes.
Bioramas, yeah. Okay, and what are the steps that you have to do to create your bioramas?
Okay, let's make a remark before answering your question to avoid misunderstanding. I talked about the hospital, and I worked long in the hospital, but let's be clear, I never made an X-ray with animals with hospital equipment in the hospital. I have my own X-ray machine in my I hire a room in and I have a license to use that X-ray machine here for one thing, I have a license to make X-ray images for dead animals, flowers, and plants. That's it. When I have a problem with my hand, I'm not allowed to make an X-ray of it. When my cat has problems with their feet, I'm not allowed to make an X-ray of it. That's for the vet, and my hand is for the hospital or the physician. So only a license for dead animals, flowers, plants. That's it. And the first step is to find dead animals. Where can I find dead animals? Now, most of my animals I find as traffic victims along the roadside. Mainly the mammals and the birds. And reptiles I can buy. Because there are breeders, and the reptiles come out the eggs in the terrarium. And when a reptile dies, I can buy it or get it from the breeder. So reptiles is not a problem. And insects, you can buy in shops. Butterflies, dragonflies and so on, you can also simply buy. For me, the most interested animals are the animals that live in freedom, that live around me. But that are animals, they are protected. That are animals you can't buy. So I have to find them. And that's why I look when I drive my car along the road to find that animals. And I found a lot. So that's step one, to get that animals. And then when I have found an animal, then I look what kind of plants or flowers I can combine with that animal. And flowers and plants I can easily buy. In the shops here in the Netherlands, there are flowers from all over the world. If I buy a reptile, a dead reptile from let's say from Italy, a chameleon or something like that, I easily can buy orchids or other plants that does not grow here, but they are in shops. So then I have my plants, my flowers, I have my animal. And then I build my diorama. So I take a X-ray film. I'll show one. Can you see it? Here is a sheet. It's 33.41 centimeters. And inside this light-tight envelope, there is a X-ray negative. Now, on that X-ray negative, I position my animal, my chameleon. I position my flowers. There you can see I built my complete diorama. Here it is. Then I take the film with the diorama. I walk over to my X-ray machine. I position it on the floor. The X-ray machine is above it, about 1 meter above it. And then beam on, and the X-ray is made. And after that, of course, I have to, it's an analog method. I do not use a digital detector. That's too expensive for me. In the hospital, they make hundreds of X-rays a day. So they can afford a digital detector, a large digital detector. But for me, it's too expensive. So I work analog with silver bromide X-ray negatives. I have to develop them. So I have a processing machine. And then when the X-ray comes out, it's a black and white image, of course. X-rays doesn't recognize colors. And it's an analog negative. And I like to have it in my computer. So I scan that, I digitize that X-ray negative. I have a scanner which digitize that large format X-ray negatives. And then you will understand when it's in the computer, I can do what I like. But now the only thing I do is level the image a bit and partly color it. That's it. So I want to remark that the complete diorama is imaged in one shoot, in one step, on one X-ray negative. Let's explain. I do not make an X-ray of the animal, finished, that's it. And then I make an X-ray separately of the flowers, okay, finished. And then in the computer, I put the animal between the flowers. No. The whole scene is pictured in one session.
And that's great, yeah.
That is a bit difficult. And maybe you have time and I can explain what is the difficulty. And then also you will I think it's of importance that I am a physicist and that I worked for years and years in the hospital with X-rays. I think I know a bit about the properties of the X-rays. Because let's say, I take an example. I hope you can see it. This is an image. Can you see it?
Yeah.
This is an image of a moorhen, a bird, a water bird, a moorhen between some flowers.
Yeah.
Irises. And yeah, there is a enormous difference in thickness between the body of that moorhen and the petals of that flowers. And the petals, to picture the petals, very low energy X-rays are needed. As I told before, I need low energy X-rays. The petals have to absorb some of my X-ray radiation to be pictured, to be imaged. But that low energy X-rays do not pass the moorhen. So the moorhen isn't imaged. No, for the moorhen, I need high energy X-rays to pass through that moorhen. But that high energy X-rays pass through the petals without any absorption, without imaging them. So on one hand, I need low energy X-rays, and on the other hand, I need high energy for the same diorama. And that's a puzzle. And that took me a long time to optimize that. And now that I have made a lot of images, I know how I can combine that a bit low energy and a bit high energy, and that all together results in an X-ray where also the thick part, the moorhen, as well as the thin part, the petals, are visible.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah, but I at some moment it stops. Thin animals is not a problem. Even butterflies with very, very, very low in energy, X-ray energy, they can be imaged. Medium thick animals is not a problem. Not too thick animals is not a problem. But at some time, it doesn't work anymore. I think thicker than a fox, that doesn't work. Of course, I can make an X-ray of a fox. That's not a problem. I can even make an X-ray of a cow. I can even make an X-ray of a horse. But to combine that thick animal, like a cow, with flowers and plants, doesn't work anymore. Then the difference in thickness is too large. So yeah. In my application, it stops with, let's say, a fox.
Yeah. It's a great job also combining these different energies of X-rays. And it's really interesting because your job is an interesting application of physics and some some art. We can call it also art or creations in general.
Okay.
Yes, I understand that background in physics, yes, is really important in this job. The knowledge about X-rays and how to work with them.
Yeah.